Dr. Youmn Hamaki, a former member of the Shura Council and professor of political science. She will be tackling the first segment of this evening's discussion regarding the economic potential of this rich continent, followed with another distinguished gentleman that will be shedding light on the political cooperation and strengthening the African Horn. Dr. Youmn, a pleasure to have you with us.
Thank you, Dean.
A very rich continent.
Yes.
Lots of human and natural resources. We're not lacking of anything,
yes.
Yet the lowest per capita income, the lowest GDP, the poorest nations in this region. Why?
Why? Actually, a lot of reasons, actually, and these reasons are multidimensional, which means it's not just a political reason regarding democracy and the political system. But at the same time, you know, the dominance of multinational and post-colonial countries, they directed these countries to the benefit of their to their own benefit, regardless the benefit of the continent itself, which means that you are going to find that each post-colonist, like British, you know, French, they are dominating completely economic activities in this in relevant countries. And from here it comes that for their own interest, not to deepen the industrial sector, so that these countries should rely all the time on importation of these countries. And at the same time, the multinationals of these countries are exploiting all natural resources. And you know that when you are exploiting natural resources, the terms of trade is always in the benefit of developed countries and against developing countries, which means that if these African countries are always exporting raw materials and the prices of raw materials are always you know, low prices compared to those manufactured goods that are imported from, you know, developed countries. So here, the terms of trade is always against African countries compared to developed countries. From here it comes that this the result of the continent, despite that for the last decade, you know, the continent witnessed the, you know, highest rate of growth. Some of the countries, African countries, witnessed the highest rate of growth compared to other developing countries. Still, the dominance of raw materials, you know, compared to the industrial sector, which means that, you know, the slogan of this summit has been how to build on human resources capabilities, how to invest on capital, you know, resources, human resources. And this is shedding the light on what is the position of human resources. They are suffering from lack of education, lack of training, lack of capabilities, problems regarding educational systems, the health services. All these are forming to large extent the capabilities of African youth and affecting seriously the capabilities of, you know, exploiting resources in the African continent.
This summit, how can we capitalize? And when I say we, not only am I talking about Egypt, which is one of the forefront questions, but maybe how could this pave further economic cooperation between us in this continent, taking into account there is a lot of meddling in that continent?
Yes, I agree with you. And, you know, this conference is quite important. You know, we can witness for the last decade that you know, most developing countries are trying seriously to have their impact on Africa or to benefit from African resources. You always find, you know, Japanese African summit, Chinese African summit, European African summit, in which they are discussing the potential of economic cooperation, and they are trying to, you know, find their, you know, steps into the continent in order to benefit from its resources. But still, regarding the relation with Egypt, Egypt could play a significant role. Egypt could be a hub for all investment coming from developed countries into the African countries. And we used to have very strong relations, economic relations. We used to have our companies that, you know, paved the way to commercial relations between African countries and Egypt. But for the last 3 decades, we, you know, neglected completely our relation, and which affected seriously this relation and weakened to large extent our economic cooperation with the African countries. After the revolution, actually, the political, you know, there is a very political support towards enhancing our economic relation with Africa, as well as political. And from here, you know, for the last 2 years, there has been great effort in order to pave the way for more relation with Africa, which actually has succeeded so far. I believe that, you know, President Sisi took for 2 years, you know, the responsibility of having, you know, to be ahead of, you know, climate change actions. And yes, from here it comes that President Sisi had a speech in Paris summit about the climate change, and in which there was a decision about having the 17 goals of sustainable development. And Egypt has a significant role towards addressing the main challenges in the African countries regarding climate change and how we can build on it from economic point of view, which means that we have a lot of potentialities regarding renewable energy.
Yes.
Egypt has addressed this topic, you know, seriously from 2 years ago. We started to have transfer of technology. We addressed several companies Egypt and to invest, and we have a tariff for this renewable energy, specifically for solar and wind energy. So from here it comes that we can be a hub for the African countries regarding how to enhance, you know, using renewable energy in order to address, you know, climate change from one perspective, from another, to try to achieve the 17 sustainable development goals, which are quite essential for the situation of Africa, since Africa is going to be affected seriously by climate change. We know quite well, we have a lot of researches specifying to how extent the African continent is going to suffer from diseases, for example, from, you know, disasters, from floods and
natural
so on.
Disasters, yes.
And I believe that we have to take into consideration the gender perspective from that, since in Africa, 40% of agricultural activities dominated by women, and women are suffering from poverty in Africa, and they are suffering a lot, actually, and they are going to be affected seriously by the impact of climate change. So Egypt can do a lot in order. We have a lot of experiences towards, you know, the empowerment of women, how to eradicate poverty, what, how can we do that regarding using, you know, micro enterprises, economic activities, how to address women properly. From here it comes that a lot of issues that should be addressed in order to have more economic cooperation between Egypt and the continent.
These issues are well, but there is also another thing, and that is the world food shortage.
Yes.
We are heading into a food crisis.
Yes.
And luckily, we are a continent which is very rich. We have a lot of agricultural lands. We have a lot of labor. And yet, we have food shortage. Is there? Can we hope that conferences like this will build on creating some kind of a food basket for this region?
Yes, this is quite important, since we have some Arab countries from the Gulf. They are nowadays having projects in African countries in order to cultivate land for their own, you know, to be exported into these countries regarding grain, wheat, and other representing food supply. I believe this kind of mutual projects for the benefit of all these countries can be quite important. Why? Because we are investing, you know, in Egypt we have technical experience, and in Gulf countries they have, you know, resources specifically. We can have this kind of organization in order to exploit the resources of African continent for the benefit of, for mutual benefit of all sides. They can benefit from that. African countries have a shortage of finance, sources of finance. They have shortage of technical experience and transfer of technology. From here it comes, you know, and we have actually, as economists, we have a lot of feasibility studies regarding how this could be done, and we have some experiences. So what we have to build on it, to fill this gap and the shortage in food specifically for the continent as a whole. So this is one important perspective in order to have cooperation, but most important of that, the industrialization of the continent. Because you know that all raw materials are exported. Even for the Egyptian experience, we are exporting our raw materials
and producing and importing
mineral resources and so on. So what we have to do here is that we have to, you know, exploit our resources. We have to open opportunities of job for youth, you know, and this is, it should be a main goal for all African continents, since we are, as continents, suffering from very high rate of unemployment, the highest in the whole world. And from here it comes that this should be a very important goal, how to specify, you know, investments that are feasible. And how, and they are actually, they should be labor intensive in order to attract, how to improve the skills of youth in order to direct them to the right positions, and specifically for technical education, vocational training. These are quite important in order to to make
the continent more industrial.
This is quite important, you know. Instead of relying all the time on importation, we have to produce our own products that we are in need of, according to the, you know, comparative advantages that we have. And here it comes that we have three now free trade areas that they are going to be joined together. You know, COMESA and SADC, and you know, another you know, free trade area which compose 20 African countries, half of the continent approximately. And from here it comes that if we build, you know, we have the institutional capacity building in order to direct resources.
Can we do this on our own?
You know. In 2015, there was a very important conference held in Sharm el-Sheikh here in Egypt in order to declare, or the announcement of, you know, these three free trade areas are going to be one free trade area.
Yes,
and after this announcement, we have to work hard regarding specifying rules of origin, because this is quite important to rules of origin, which is the responsibility of ministries of industry in the African countries. You know, following up is quite essential and important. And another thing that is affecting seriously all economic integration is the institutional capacity building for this institution. Like, if we consider the EU countries as the most successful experience of that, you still find some defect in their
some
institutional
problems. Which are surfacing now more than ever.
But we have to learn from their experience. because they have a very, advanced experience regarding how to achieve integration. Now, if you compare that, you can find in this last summit to African countries, one of the main challenges is how to form this institutional capacity building and to how extent you can specify roles and responsibilities and how this institutional capacity building can be successful to achieve the goals and to achieve, you know, the hopes of Africa towards more integration. The African Union is doing well, but still needs a lot of things to be done in order to, strengthen their role internationally, since they have some challenges regarding application of democracy and the political conflicts that these conflicts are affecting seriously the stabilization in the continent. And from here it comes that if you have a strong, institutional building, you can do a lot regarding addressing these challenges.
Dr. Youmn, what advice would you be giving to the Egyptian businessmen into how to integrate and cooperate within this continent?
Actually, what we need, number one, it's we should have a cooperation between the government, our government, and the African government in order to specify the rules of origin, because this is essential for any type of investment and, commercial relation. This is from one perspective. From another, I believe that we need investment map to specify all, resources in the continent. We need to have investment maps, and we need to have visibility study and to try to rely to civil society, industrial federation, like business councils, all these they can work in order to have to specify the mutual benefit among businessmen and women in the continent, so that they can find their opportunities for the benefit of activating investment. If you succeed to activate investment along the continent, this will be completely reflected on the size of trade. And this is actually the core of any economic integration.
Dr. Youmn Hamaki, thank you very much for your fruitful input. And politics and economics are two sides or two faces to the same coin. Lots of political tension within that continent. Can the economic vehicle push the problems out of the way and have a fully developed African Horn or not would be under discussion in the second segment, so please stay with us.
At the site of the event. Information on events as they are happening. If it's breaking news, it's Nile TV.